volunteered at Nashville Mission, where they have a two-part program where they feed the homeless. So anybody that is homeless can come there and get food for the day.
Not only does the program take in homeless, but it also has a seven-month program where they teach the people skills that they can then take out into the real world. There's also some sort of, it's not exactly 12-step, but it is some kind of substance abuse program that helps them with whatever they need help with. And it also has a strong focus on service. So a lot of the people that we were back in the kitchen with today, helping prepare the food and serve the food, were people that are in the program and are almost done with the program or have graduated from the program. And one guy that I met named Mike, he was saying that he was so thankful for the program because before it, he never knew that service was such a huge part of what really fed him and was one of the passions in his life. And since the program, he now knows that service is where he wants to focus when he gets out, which is so great.
The program that I'm in is the Life Recovery Program at the Nashville Rescue Mission in Nashville, Tennessee. The program offers more than just a hot meal and a place to sleep. It has different educational programs. It helps get your GED. It offers an opportunity to build a relationship spiritually. For those that don't have it or those that have it straight away. And the program has been so good to me. It's not only gave me a place to stay, but it offered me a peace of mind. I found a home church here. I was baptized here in Nashville November the 13th of this year. I graduated the program this year. It's a seven-month program. It offers leads for jobs and things of that nature. And it's a really good program. I can't just say how much it's meant to me and how much it has done.
Church at the River, and they were there just as long getting the food ready, cleaning up, collecting the trays, but there were also little ones there too with their little hairnets on and aprons, and they were right there with us serving food. It was just cool to see at that young of an age them being involved and learning about helping others.
I just felt really grateful that we are even able to do this, able to go around to different states and meet different people, hear all of their stories, I mean, there's people that have come from, you know, everywhere there. Nobody's from the same place, and everybody has a unique story of how they ended up there. And it's been so incredible just hearing the story, being touched by their story, seeing how far they've come in the program and how much they said that they've changed and what they've learned, and how they've found their own passion and their own dreams by being given a second chance through this organization. It just felt like a really special place to be. We are going to pay parking meters for people here on the street on Broadway in Nashville, Tennessee.
Yay!
Yeehaw! This is Drew.
Oh yeah, we wrangled us a local.
I know where all the meters are.
Working with PTM was such a great experience also in how organized they were. They had so many different programs, you know, from lunch and mentoring kind of things to having after school, like dinner and homework type events and activities. Being there and seeing the way they were with the kids was really cool too, because you could just tell that they really loved these kids. They knew their names and they just had such a vested interest in their well-being. So to be there also and seeing, you know, how awesome they're doing and how they've grown in the last couple of years, which they said they've had to move locations and get a bigger space. I just wanted to, you know, say it was an honor and a pleasure working with PTM, and I'm just so grateful that there's organizations like that out there that really care about the kids and care about them having great experience and growing and learning and being successful in life.
What do you thinking of, man? What you do and what you think you can do, what you are, what you do, looking out at ripples on the dance floor, man. What you mean, that's what you get. Did you forget to know what the end is? To begin, clearing, looking out at ripples on the dance floor. Machine, did you get everything you asked for?
PTM had really great volunteers and really great people running the organization. Sarah, who pretty much led the whole thing. She
Wonder Woman
knew all the kids and everything that they needed and led the assembly, led us, the volunteers, helped us know what to do. Then we had some volunteers from high school that were there, come there every week, and then people that are from all over the U.S. We had somebody there that had been there for 12 out of the 13 years, coming there every week. It was just really great to see what a community, not just the kids were, but just the people that worked there and volunteered and helped out. It seemed like everybody was just a big family.
Snake, a charm on the dance floor, the dance floor, dance floor.
When we picked up the kids from the bus, there was one girl who was the last one out of the bus, and I was at the back of the line, and she started talking to me immediately, and I just felt an instant connection with her. And most of it felt to me like it was just somebody was paying attention to her, and somebody was there to give her love and help and be there just to talk to her. It just made me feel like they were so starved for physical connection and love. And it was just so simple for us just to be there and provide that.
I felt like I was able to make an impact, even if it was just one page of homework that we were doing, for someone to really take the time to teach them and also to tell them that they were doing a good job and just cheer them on. It was such a cool feeling to see right away that they were being impacted by that and that they wanted to do a better job because they had somebody telling them, you can do it, you're doing an awesome job. So it felt really good to be that person, to instill that in them. Really fulfilling.
Being there felt really important to me. The best way I could have thought to spend my time.
This week for me has been pretty amazing in that we were able to actually be in one place for longer than 2 days and serve in so many different ways. There were 3 different things, 2 volunteering things that we did and the random act of kindness that we did in downtown Nashville. And it was really cool to have not only an opportunity for us to give so much in such a concentrated amount of time, but what you were saying earlier, I felt like we were being taken care of, being with Tristan, mm-hmm. who's a friend of yours.
I agree. I also think that I just keep coming to how amazing it is to feel a part of a community, even when you don't live in the community. You know, Tristan, who we've been staying with for almost a week, has completely taken us in his family, let us be in the house, you know, showed us downtown. Mm-hmm. And that has really allowed us to be free to go serve in lots of different ways and for a longer period of time than we're used to, which is really cool.
Yeah.
And I've been thinking for this week, one theme that keeps showing up is the idea of family, that you have loved ones everywhere you go.
Yeah.
And you can have loved ones even in a place that you don't live. Mm-hmm. And we keep finding that time and time again. And I feel really grateful for even being able to experience that by being here.
Yeah. So it is. It's this sense of, like, if you're open to it and open to building community wherever you go, it can happen. But it's you being open to the giving and receiving of, like, that family love,
mm-hmm.
whether it's actual family or not, which, you know, is big thing for me.
With that, with what you were saying, there was a feeling I had in both of the places that we went to volunteer this week that both of them had such a sense of family within them.
PTM, which was an after-school program for kids, K through 12. The staff and volunteers and the kids all felt like such a family. They all knew each other. They had little, you know, dances and songs that they did together, and it felt like a really tight-knit community. Mm-hmm. Same with the Nashville Mission, which is the homeless shelter that we were at yesterday. It was, there's such a camaraderie between everybody that it felt like a really close family, and that theme is just kind of transcended through the whole week.
This whole week.
Yeah. And also with family, you know, we're family now. Me and you and Kat and Coach.
And Coach.
You know, we're out here on the road. We're being together, communicating, cooking together, and that's all family style familiness. One thing that came to my mind is if you take in people, if you serve others, mm-hmm. and help others, mm-hmm. that you will also be helped. That's available for you. Mm-hmm. You know, mm-hmm. I mean, that doesn't sound very clear, but in my mind it was kind of like, you know, we're out here trying to help people make their day better, serve, volunteer, do whatever we can, and we've been just constantly meeting people who are taking us in.
Right.
And helping us.
Yeah.
Be able to do what we're doing.
Right. Well, and it makes me think of also just all of the people that have donated. You know, all, which, by the way, thank you all so much. Like, honestly, we could not do this without you. But that feeling of, you know, if you're doing something to make an impact in the world and inspire and be of service, that people will want to come along, will want to be a part of. So all of you that donated, you know, we totally feel like you're part of this. You're here with us. You're, every time we're, you know, volunteering, we're thinking of all the people that have made this possible, you know, because we wouldn't be able to do it without you. So it is, it's being a part of something greater.
You could say something about how when you go out and you're putting yourself out there and you're giving your energy into something so positive and something bigger than yourself, mm-hmm. then you become a part of that thing that's bigger than yourself, which is also a family. Because mm-hmm. that's kind of the definition of family. It's something more than just you. It's your connectedness, and it's the relationships that you have with other people.
Mm-hmm. It's the whole. It's not the individual pieces, but the whole that's greater than the individual pieces kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. I really like the way you said that. You want to just say it?
I just did.
All right, then. And there's Kat with her wisdom.
Once you just again. Dub our mouths saying it. We're like,
family.
I think this week needs a family bomb.
Ooh, yeah. Okay. Ready? Family bomb! We can't die in this one because it's a family bomb, guys.
My grandma and your grandma were sitting by the fire. My grandma told your grandma, I'm gonna set your flag on fire. You're talking about hit now, hit now, hit now. Aiko, aiko, ande. Giacomo Fino, anane. Giacomo Finane. Look at my king all dressed in red. Aiko, aiko, ande. I bet you $5 he'll kill you dead. Giacomo Finane.
What are you doing? He's just staring longingly at his butt.
Here I go. Here I go again, girls. What's my weakness? Men. Okay, then. Chillin', minding my business. You saw to look around and I couldn't believe this. I swear, I stare, my niece, my witness. The brother had it going on with something kinda, kick it, wait. I forget.
Aiko, aiko, ande. He's not a man, he's a loving machine. Giacomo Finale, talking about him now. Aiko, aiko, ande. Giacomo Finale, Giacomo Finale. Hey now, hey now, hey now, I go, I'm there.